Now we are ready for release pipeline. Before creating or starting release pipeline, let me create a deployment group. Click on deployment groups. Deployment group is a group of target machine on which we are deploying our artifact. In this demonstration, we are creating three deployment group. One for development, second for QA, and last one is production. So click on add a deployment group. Go ahead and create. It is going to create a deployment group. We need to select a types of the target machine. It can be a Windows or Linux machine. We are going to deploy a ASP.NET application, hence our target machine will be a Windows machine. Now we require to add target machine in deployment group. To register a target machine with this deployment group, we have to run this PowerShell script on a target machine. This is my IIS development machine. I need to register this machine with dev deployment group. We need to run this PowerShell script to register the machine with this deployment group. Check mark this option and copy the script to the clipboard. Now go on the machine and run the PowerShell as a admin privilege. Run that script. It is going to download a Azure agent on C drive. It successfully connected and registered with the deployment group. Give the tag for the deployment group. Say yes. And provide the tag. You can provide any tag. Now provide the account name under which you want to run the Azure agent service. I am okay with the default one. The activity has been completed. Let's verify. Go back your Azure DevOps console and click on targets. Now you can see here one machine successfully added into this deployment group. You can add as many as machine you want. Let's follow the same steps for QA and production deployment groups. I'm creating new one. Let's register the QA machine with this group. This is my QAIS machine. Say yes. Now provide the tag. It successfully registered with the deployment group QA. Go back your Azure DevOps console and click on targets. One machine successfully added into the QA deployment groups. This machine is currently offline. It will take some time to be online. Now you can see here both the dev and QA machine is up and online in my deployment groups. Let's create a final deployment group, prod. This is my production machine and I am going to execute this PowerShell script on the production machine. Say yes and provide the tag name. Enter the username. It successfully connected. Let's verify in Azure DevOps console. Check under the targets. Yes, it's connected. Go to the deployment groups. And you can see here machine in each deployment group is active and online. We are ready to create release pipeline. Before creating release pipeline, let me show you the application or website in IIS on each environment. This is my development machine. and we are going to deploy our code on ESOP application. Let me browse the application on the browser. Currently, this application doesn't have any code. This is the QA environment. This is the QA environment URL. This is my production environment, and I can access my production environment with this URL. Now we are ready to create a multi-stage release pipeline with the approval.